एवरीवन, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर सुगंधा खंगार वाघ, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स, महात्मा फुले आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड सीताराम जी चौधरी साइंस महाविद्यालय वरुड. हियर द सेशन इज डिपेंड्स ऑन अर्थक्वेक फॉर BSc सेकेंड ईयर सेमिस्टर 3. दिस इज़ माई 6th लेक्चर विच इज़ बेस्ड ऑन एटमोसफियर एंड जियो फिजिक्स, दैट इज सब टॉपिक इज अर्थक्वेक. नाउ see the outlines. It includes earthquake, that is introductory part of earthquake, causes of earthquake, terminologies associated with earthquake. Now see here the causes of earthquake, how earthquake occurs, what are the type of earthquakes we can say. Here, causes of earthquake means the classification of earthquake or the types of earthquake. Here, tectonic earthquakes, and another one is non-tectonic earthquakes, or we can say here non-tectonic cause. Before this, what we have studied in previous lecture, we will see. I am showing this slide what we have studied earlier. We have studied earlier as a parts of earth, as a planet, that is introductory part, then its scientific investigation also, then the ideas about lithosphere, hydrosphere and the composition of the atmosphere, that is what amount of gases, moisture present in the mixture, that is depends on the composition of atmosphere. Now come towards, as per the classification of earthquake, there are two types of the earthquake, and that is tectonic earthquake and non-tectonic earthquake, or we can say non-tectonic cause. So see here first the tectonic earthquake. It is believed that tectonic earthquake is caused due to sudden displacement of blocks, along the faults or fractures we can say. Many theories have been given for explaining the rupture and thereby generating the vibrations of earthquake. High frequency reed proposal, the elastic rebound theory, which is widely used for this. Now see here, the tectonic earthquake can be explained on the basis of rebound theory. See here, according to this theory, rocks are believed to work as a elastic material. Now what is exactly the elastic material? As we see the example of rubber, easiest example is rubber, glass, these are the elastic material. So how to define it? The material which regain its original shape and size after removal of external deforming force. जैसे अगर हमने रबर को स्ट्रेच किया, स्ट्रेच करने के बाद क्या होता है, रबर की साइज शेप चेंज हो जाता है, और जैसे ही हमने उसको छोड़ दिया मीन्स वो अपने ओरिजिनल शेप और साइज पे आता है, दैट इज़ कॉल्ड एज इलास्टिक मटेरियल. दैट्स वाई आई हैव टेकन हियर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ रबर एज ए इलास्टिक मटेरियल. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू रिबाउंड थियरी, rocks are believed to work as elastic material. When these elastic materials are stressed, the rock tries to bend. When stress is increased continuously and cross the elastic limit, the rock material, that is the blocks of rock, rupture and there is displacement of blocks along the surface. This causes the breaking of rocks and produce relative displacement along the rock surfaces. According to rebound theory again, the displacement is associated with readjustment or rebound of surface produced due to its rupture. Rock on either sides of the fault try to take its original shape because the elasticity of rock considered by this theory. Now see here, rocks on either side of fault try to take its original shape. Means जैसे मैंने explain किया था what is elasticity, it is the property to regain its original size and shape. To regain, regain means regain, वो अपना shape ले लेता है. वैसे ही rocks on either sides of fault try to take its original shape because the elasticity of rock considered by this theory. It is due to the elasticity property only. During the readjustment process, most of the elastic energy stored and released suddenly in the form of seismic waves at the plane place of displacement. The main stock is due to this region. After the main stock, many minor shocks are recorded for many months because the medium, that is the material, tries to restore to a state of equilibrium. During this process, there is release of residual. The concept of plate tectonic is that earthquake occurs along the boundaries of the plates moving over each other. Now come towards non-tectonic causes. Before showing these non-tectonic causes, if you have any difficulty according to rebound theory, you can post me on my WhatsApp, personal WhatsApp, or you can chat me while the online session, live online session. Because my voice is not audible to you for many of these session. I tried many times. That's why it is necessary to play that video with you. That is either PDF or YouTube video. Then there will be no net problem. And that's why I made here the YouTube videos. Now come towards the non-tectonic causes. It includes the vibration produced due to the explosion of volcano, atomic explosions. Now what is mean by volcano here? That is the question. Volcano means the vibrations produced in the earth. A shock of earthquake may be produced due to any one of the following mechanism. Due to forceful sudden eruption of lava and gases from the volcanoes having large pressure. Due to explosion of volcano itself, collapse the center of the volcano into the space formed due to the removal of gases and the molten matter. Now see here, volcano means the vibration produced in the earth, and due to this all these changes occur here. A new cause of earthquake associated with improving the water in artificially created reservoirs. See here, this is also important point. The new cause of earthquake associated with impounding of water in the artificially created reservoir. Such type of earthquake is called as reservoir associated with earthquake. Earthquake associated with filling of water in reservoir have been recorded from many parts of the world. But there is no agreement on filling the water in the reservoir gives an additional load on the strata at the base of the reservoir will be the single cause of the earthquake. If this is so, then shock should have been recorded from all the major reservoirs of the world, but this is not so. However, it believed that some regions which are already critically stress means, as you know, stress and strain, force per unit area stress, earthquake would be caused due to filling of water in that reservoir. When water is stored in such reservoir, the pore pressure on the basin rock increases extremely, which produces the adverse effect to the strength of the rock. It may lead to their failures, which will be the reason of seismic shock. Now terminology associated with earthquake. Now see here the seismology. What is seismology? So that definition is highlighted here. It is the branch of science in which there is the study of earthquake. It includes partly geology and partly physics. It's called as seismology. What is this? The branch of science which deals with the study of earthquake, and it also includes the geology, as this unit is completely depends on geology, we can say, that is the atmosphere and geophysics, and partly physics also. The word seismic is used to indicate anything related to the earthquake. For example, seismic waves, seismic intensity, etc. Now focus. An earthquake originates at some depth below the surface of the earth. The exact point of the origin of an earthquake below the surface of the earth is known as focus, and it is also known as hypocenter. See here, the exact point of the origin of earthquake below the surface of the earth is known as focus, or it is also called as the hypocenter. Now epicenter, come towards this point. It is the point on the surface of the earth vertically above the focus of the earthquake. Now, what are the seismic waves? See here, definition is given. These are the elastic waves which are generated from the focus of the earthquake, are known as seismic waves. So, what are seismic waves? Seismic waves are generated during the earthquake only. And how to define it? These are the elastic waves which are generated from the focus of the earthquake, are known as seismic waves. There are three types of the seismic waves, that is the P wave, L wave and S wave. Now come towards P wave. See here, these are called as primary waves. These are also longitudinal in nature. These waves travel faster in the rigid rocks. These waves can travel through solid and solid material inside the earth. Now come towards S waves. These waves are called as the secondary waves. These waves are the transverse in nature. These waves cannot travel through the liquid. So it helps in knowing the nature of the interior of the earth. Now L waves, these are called as long wave or the surface wave. See here, the L waves are called as the long wave or surface waves. These waves are complex in nature, that is partly longitudinal and partly transverse in nature. Isosismal line or isocyst. It is an imaginary line joining all the points where the intensity of earthquake is same. See, note this point. It is an imaginary line joining all the points where the intensity of earthquake is same. Homosismal or homocyst. It is an imaginary line joining the place where the shocks arrive at the same time. These are small definitions, but that are very much important. Now tsunami. Have you heard the word tsunami? Yes, means you have heard. I think you heard this. It is Japanese word. Its meaning is coastal waves. It is related to an earthquake that occurs in the ocean floors and can vertical displacement in oceanic crust and cause the vertical displacement in oceanic crust. At this time, very large water waves on the surface of the ocean are produced. These waves are termed as tsunami. Now, the types of earthquake. Earthquakes are classified on the basis of depth of the focus, the magnitude of earthquake and the cause of the origin. See here, I have drawn the tree diagram, that is earthquake which are depends upon the focus of the earth, magnitude of earthquake and the cause of origin. On the basis of depth of focus, see here, shallow focus earthquake. In this case, focus lies below the earth's surface up to 60 km, that focus on this point. Then the intermediate focus earthquake. In this case, the focus lies below the earth's surface between 60 to 300 km. And third point is deep focus earthquake. In this case, the focus lies below the earth's surface between 300 to 700 km. So that one, that is the third one, deep focus earthquake is more dangerous compared to shallow focus earthquake. On the basis of magnitude, intensity of earthquake is mentioned by its magnitude on the Richter scale. Intensity scale is given by whole number in ascending order. Each number indicates the effect due to earthquake. As number increases, effect also increases. Now see here, intensity scale is given by whole number, and if number increases, effect, earthquake effect also increases. Depending on this number, earthquakes are classified as a minor or major earthquake. On the basis of focus of origin, here tectonic earthquake, these are caused due to the relative displacement of blocks of fault in the crust of the earth. Now non-tectonic earthquakes, that is the volcanic earthquake, vibrational earthquake, their origin of cause is totally different from the faults and relative displacement of the block. Their origin is volcanic eruptions, atomic explosions, etc. Submarine earthquakes. This earthquake that occurs in the ocean floor generates very large wave on the surface of the ocean, which destroy the coastal areas. These submarine earthquakes are termed as tsunami. So in this way, we have studied the types of earthquake and the causes of earthquake also, which earthquake is most dangerous and which one is light earthquake. Now see, we have discussed on the basis of depth of the focus of the earthquake. Here, if depth of the focus is shallow, that is, it is less in kilometer, then it is not dangerous. But if deep focus earthquake is there, that is, its range is in between 300 to 700 kilometer, and that's why this is more dangerous. So these are the ideas about earthquake, and the remaining we will study in next lecture. Thank you so much. So if you see this lecture, and if you see this lecture again, you can subscribe my channel as a Sugandha Khangar on YouTube. You can see this lecture on my YouTube channel. So write down in Chrome or YouTube, search as a Sugandha Khangar, and you can see this lecture number of times, and you also prepare your notes according to lecture. Thank you so much.